starting a long bikepacking tour. The bike weighs a ton, full of water, full of food. I'm fresh. I haven't been riding for days, weeks at end, so I have a ton of energy. And it's those moments before the hardships start, while you just have this great sense of adventure, that I feel the most free. My name is Chaz Christensen. I'm from Oakland, California, and I'm an artist. I really started riding bikes seriously in about 2005 in Portland, Oregon. And I had a cyclocross bike because that's just kind of the bike that the local bike shop sold me. And then I found out about cyclocross racing, and then I found out about bike messengers, and then it was kind of all downhill from there.
I got a bike to get to work and to get around. And strangely, it kind of turned from this utility to something that I was really passionate about, to the point where all I could think about when I wasn't biking was where I was gonna ride to next. My name is Nico Deportago Cabrera. I'm from Chicago, Illinois. And oftentimes when bikepacking, you're faced with this situation that makes you question, what the hell am I doing out here? Why are you doing this? There's no point to any of this.
The mental challenges are the ones that can make or break a trip. Talking to myself out loud was how I coped with that, and
I'm trying really hard.
I think there was definitely some random people out in the desert that probably gave me a second glance, hearing me sometimes screaming punk pop lyrics to myself. And for me, when things get really tough, either physically or emotionally, music is one of the things that I really use to bring myself back up.
Anytime I'm on my bike, I feel free. And, you know, that could be something as simple as a mountain bike trail 20 minutes from my apartment, or in the middle of some crazy gravel road in Andorra, or like somewhere in the Pyrenees. You're kind of forced to think about just the very minimum that you need to get by each day. And I really enjoy that.
There's a lot of different schools of thought when it comes to preparing for bike tours. People share pack lists that are pages long. They check the weather every day for 2 weeks leading up to when they leave, double checking the route, triple checking the route. And then there's kind of the fast and loose, where you just stuff a lot of stuff into your bike box or pack your bags morning of and roll out and see what happens. Because no matter how much you plan and prepare for a bike tour, things are gonna change. Not everything is gonna go perfectly. So if you're frustrated and angry because things aren't going the way you planned the whole time, you're gonna miss out on the fact that things are happening and the bike tour is going on around you.
The most precious moments that I've found bikepacking are the spaces in between that I would have never otherwise experienced had I not like chosen to go down this one road or decided to pull over in this one little town.
Some of the precious moments come at the worst times, and sometimes everything just clicks and you finish your route right as the sun is setting and you roll up to your preferred campsite and no one's there and you've got a great view, and the satisfaction of sitting down and unpacking your bike and kind of just setting up camp at the end of a long, hard day, it enriches the experience and it enriches the things that I'm seeing, and it makes it mean a little more because I'm putting in such an effort to travel and see these things. And the thing that I really love about bikepacking is being self-sufficient when I'm out on an adventure.